In this demonstration, we'll take a look at some of the ribbon and group changes in Excel 2016. Let's take a look. Excel 2016 has made some cosmetic changes to the ribbon. For example, you'll now see that you're able to use the Share button. Now the Share button will allow you to view who's currently in the document, and if it's being shared with other users, and give you access to sharing options. Now you should note that sharing options is a feature that is available in the Word and PowerPoint applications as well. So, you'll notice when I click on the Share button, which is located on the ribbon here at the top right-hand side, that the Share window will come up on the right-hand side of our document. And this is going to enable us to save the worksheet to a cloud location, such as OneDrive. This will allow us to collaborate with other users, make changes, and allow other users to make changes as well, and see the various changes between users. Now, if I close up the Share window, let's take a look at another option here. You'll notice in Excel 2016 that there's a new group located on the Data tab. Actually, there's two new groups. So the first one we're going to look at is called the Get and Transfer group. So let me click on the Data tab, and you'll notice on the left-hand side here, the second group that appears in our Data tab is called the Get and Transform group. We have various options here. Now there are Power Query options. You'll notice we have a button here called New Query, which will allow us to create a new Power Query. We'll also be able to click on Show Queries, which will allow us to view a list of queries in this worksheet or workbook. We'll also be able to access the From Table button, which can be used to create a new query and link it to a selected Excel table. And we can also access the Recent Sources button, which will allow us to manage and connect to any recent sources. Now, another group that has changed in Excel 2016 is the Data Tools group. You'll notice that there is a new button in here called Manage Data Model. And the Manage Data Model will allow you to go to the PowerPoint Pivot window. You'll also notice that the What If Analysis button has been moved from the Data Tools group into the Forecast group, which is also a new group that's available in Excel. So you can see here in the Forecast group, there is a What If Analysis button. And we've also got a new button here called the Forecast Sheet button. Now this button will allow you to create a new worksheet and use it to predict data trends. And lastly, if the Data Analysis Add-ins option is enabled, you'll see a new tab called Power Pivot, which is located on the ribbon as well. If you click on the Power Pivot tab, you'll notice that we have various groups in here. We have Data Model, Calculations, Table and Relationships, and also a button to access settings. And those are some of the ribbon and group changes in Microsoft Excel 2016.